Okay, the question that I got was how to do an array to average the total of a bunch of numbers. And the first thing is you don't actually need an array. What I would typically do is get an input variable amount, and let's make this in the console mode. And have an assignment count equals 0. Then we'll have a while loop while amount greater than we could either do 0 or -1. I don't know if you'd want to let people put in 0 for the total, so we're going to do -1, saying that we're not going to average negative numbers because 0 would be valid. Do an assignment, have count equal count plus 1. So that's going to be our counter. We also should have a total. And initially, we could set it out here, but we're going to just set it to 0. Okay, so we're going to have count equal count plus 1. We're going to have total equal total plus amount. And so that will keep going through as long as amount is greater than -1. We want to edit this. And then we can copy this, paste it here, because we want to check it again before we go back into the while loop. And let's give it a try. I forgot to put my quotes in here. Which means I also forgot to come here. Let's try it again. I thought I put that in console. Okay, I don't have it actually displaying anything, which would be helpful. I'm doing the average, but it's taking the input okay. So I'm testing here, and this should be console. And this one should be console. And I test whenever I'm to a reasonable stopping point. So now we've got to work on our calculation of our output. So here we're going to have output. Of around it there. That's console. And let's try it again. I can format that to look nicer. So it averages for you. So that's really the solution to what you're trying to do, where you don't know the set number of entries ahead of time. But if you want them to do something into an array, but this involves knowing how many numbers they're going to enter before they start. No, we don't want to do that. Let's just start fresh. So if you want to work with an array, we'll make an array. Numbers. And you do the same thing, except you, again, the array's not necessary for this. It really isn't needed. But let's say you want to, you know how many numbers you're going to have them input an array. So let's do a counter for loop. So from i 0 0 and 4. Okay, so that's our array. So we're going to have them input numbers I. And at the end of this, this is not the efficient way to do this, because we just have them add it to the total right here. You don't even need the array. But let's say we want to do it that way. So we're going to have another for loop. We can do the I equals 0 to 4 again. I, 0, 4, and we can have put a variable, make it equal to 0, total, equals total plus numbers I. Output, I'm not going to bother formatting this nicely. The output is just going to be total divided by 5. Console. And console. Okay, so we're going to put in 5 numbers. Darn it, I could have sworn I'd done that. Six. So it's averaging. I thought I'd put this into console mode. Okay, let's try it again. There you go. Averaging something put in by users.